Hi, I'm Hans.
Hi, I'm Michelle, and together we are Spinhundert.
Spinhundert. Michelle and I, we know each other for more than 30 years. We've been working together in the early days in bands, and we were always friends, and somehow once in a while we got together and did some projects or whatever. We did our own thing, our own path, we walked our own path, but sometimes we got together, and then it was like a pitch for an international movie. And then I was okay. I asked Michelle, you like to join me to do that pitch?
Discovered when we were doing this pitch, finally we didn't get the pitch. We got the job, but we continue to work together because we, as Hans says, we know each other so long, and we discovered something magical, maybe you could say, or maybe impressive, the fact that it was so easy to create music together. Maybe also because both of us have we know each other, but we have had a completely different path, a completely different history and development in music, and we bring that on the table together. So we feel much stronger for a specific kind of a work together. We fill up the gap that one each other has, maybe, you know? And that's what we discovered, and we appreciated also. And then we said, well, let's see. Maybe there might be some projects that we can do together to go much further in result than we could do alone. It's a discovery for us too, because honestly, I was a little careful in the beginning. I was kind of a little anxious to say, is this going to work? But then all of a sudden there was this project for Thieves of the Wood that showed up, and it was Hans again that called me saying, Michel, I think this is a job that we have to do together. Actually, we were already working in Svendundr. We were already working on our album. And all of a sudden we got this opportunity to work together as Svendundr on this film, and we just said, let's do it together, because we also felt that we both, with our experience, we could bring up additional experience to create the perfect score for this for this film. And indeed, that's what exactly happened.
The series is playing in the 18th century, but we didn't want to make music from that period, you know. We wanted to use the instruments and make like a sound library and sample the instruments and mix them and edit them and modulate them, so they have like a source, an ancient source to make modern sounds, you know. And that's how we started thinking, okay, what instruments can we use? So we started looking for those old instruments, and then we started working with them. We got them in our studio, and we started fiddling around and sampling. We couldn't play these instruments because they're sometimes very difficult, you know, like a hurdy-gurdy. Yeah, you have to know how to play it. We're not hurdy-gurdy players. But we are musicians, and we know what sounds nice. So we started sampling and detuning the instruments, and okay, sampling them and put all the samples on the keyboard, and starting making chords with those sounds, you know, and did a lot of percussion recordings with a percussion guy who has like a store, literally a store full of weird and all kinds of percussion. So we started, okay, can we use this one? And we made our own sounds library. And then we start composing. At first, the first episode we did together at my studio, and then, okay, this is like gonna be the blueprint of the sound. Now we can work separately. After we came together, but we separated the cues. Okay, you do this cue, I do that cue, and then now I think it's pretty difficult to hear what cue did you, Michel, did, and what cue did I do, you know, because we use the same source, sound source. And then afterwards we went to Budapest to do the string recordings. We went three times to to Budapest to do string recordings, because it was a lot of music.
You know, that's always a challenge. Sometimes it's a big challenge. But the good thing here was we got along. We felt that we understand the directors. There were two directors, two main directors. So we thought, okay, I think we know where we need to be there. But it is always, you never know until you do it, you know. So that was a challenge. And then the second thing is, yeah, you have this color, you have this ingredients that you're cooking with, but surviving the ingredients for 10 episodes, it's not easy, you know. You know, you have to get there for 6 months further. You know, it's a challenge that maybe after 3 episodes, you know, everything has been said musically. You know, it's difficult. So the music also evolves throughout the story also in a way. So I think that was, at least that was for my side, a challenge to continue on for working 6 months on that period. I don't know what Hans has to add on that.
I think also one of the challenges was not to fall in like cliches. It's like an epic story, so the most obvious way to make the music was like orchestral and big horns and yeah, like a kind of Hollywood kind of sound or Games of Thrones or whatever. We didn't want to do that. For one, we don't have that much of a budget here in Belgium, but we didn't want to do that. We wanted to have like an original sound, more or less an original sound, and have a lot of textures. So that's why we chose to start working with old instruments and then at the orchestra.
There were many moments in the film where we tried to touch a second layer in the story, to not be stereotype in action and go all the way in action, or when it's drama, all the way into drama, you know, one-on-one. No, that's big, mostly of the time, the booby trap, that's the trap mostly. Yeah, sometimes, you know, you have very dramatic moments, but the music goes very subtle, very delicate, you know, and that makes the drama even much more credible, I think.
We are Hans and Michel from Svenhunder. We are the composers of the Netflix series Tears of the Wood. Please watch it.